Hello, I am Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, we're going to look at Analyze Data command on the Home tab in Excel. This is a great feature. It uses artificial intelligence to look at your data. You can use natural language queries. It'll give you suggestions about your data. This is going to be part of my presentation in April and also in November at EA Ignite. April's in Baltimore and November's in Austin, Texas. So I've got two sessions. One is on Microsoft OneDrive and the other one is on analyzing financial data in Microsoft Excel. So this one falls into the financial data one. There are bookmarks and chapters so you can jump around because I'm going to show a lot of cool tips before I actually do analyze data. So if you just want to jump to the analyze data, hit show more, click on the analyze data, and you'll jump right there. Let's dive in right now. This file, I'm going to blog about it, and this file will be available for download. Analyze data is on the home tab over to the far right. It used to be called, when it initially came out, probably 3 or 4 years ago, Insights. They've changed the name to analyze data, and it sits on the home tab. The Home tab is where Microsoft has decided to put the most popular commands Excel users like to use. So before we dive in, the data, real quick, let's examine it. I've got three columns, A, B, and C, that are text fields. One column has invoice dates, and the last two columns have numeric numbers or numbers. There's two things I want to look at before we analyze data. I want to know the total number of records I have, and I also want to know how many different years that I have. If you just want to know how many records you have, you can do count A. I know everything in column A, there are no blanks. I'm going to just do A colon A. 1000 minus the header row is that's 999 records. There's that. Also, I want to know the 2 years. Instead of scrolling through here looking, turn on your filters. I like to use Control Shift and the letter L. That will toggle your filters on and off, Control Shift L. When you hit the drop down for invoice date, it's smart enough to group it by year, then by month. So I got 2 years of data. Excellent. So here comes analyze data right now. Click inside your data. Make sure your data is tabular. This is tabular data that I have. Analyze data. The Analyze Data tab opens up on the right-hand side of the screen. You really have three different sections in here. First of all is Ask a Question. We will do this one last. Next, though, is Not Sure What to Ask For, and it's given me some suggestions. Total Costs by Brand is a column chart. Percentage of Total Costs for each dealership. Yeah, like I like this one. I'm going to click it. I've got one worksheet in this file right now. It's called Chris Menard EA Ignite. When I click on this, it's going to give me worksheet number two. When I click on this chart, it'll give me worksheet number two. It says insert pivot chart. When you insert the pivot chart, you will get a pivot table with it. Now I'm going to get worksheet number two. Let's see if I'm right. There you go. And it called it suggestion number one. In real life, I would change that name of that right there. But there you go. There is that chart. Really cool. Go to chart design. If you don't like it, change it. If you don't like the chart, well, I want a pie chart. Cool. And how about some percentages? Done. Right there. The percentages are here too, but maybe I just want to print this by itself. So there is analyzed data giving me suggestions about what to ask. I'm going to hit the arrow to go back to return to my results. Now get answers like these. This first one, I actually love this first one. If I did not have analyzed data, I would actually probably make this as a pivot table anyway. It's showing me the brands running down. It's got the name of the rep. There's Carol, Art, Vandalay running across, and it's summarizing this data. Insert pivot table. This will give me worksheet number three. Zoom in so you can see this. Perfect. That is a pivot table. Back here, I'm just going to scroll down. I'm not going to do every one of these, but this is kind of a cool one. The second one, Invoice amount by rep and dealership. Notice it says pivot chart, and again, which means it's going to give you a pivot table and the pivot chart. This should be worksheet number 4, but should be suggestion number 3, and it is. Pull this down here. You know what is so cool about analyzed data? If you really knew nothing about Excel and you had this data and you clicked on that, you're like, oh, this is just good stuff. But if you know how to use Excel, pivot tables and pivot charts, you should know that in this bar chart, this is a bar chart, I happen to notice that Art Vandelay, look at the blue bar. Then look at the blue bar for Carol. That blue bar is the ABC dealership. And I'm like, ABC dealership seems to be the most popular dealership. So I know that I can change this chart. When I go to the design tab at the top, I can hit switch row column, and that'll show me the dealerships and then the reps inside the dealerships. We just discovered that ABC is the winner. So maybe I want to see it this way. And again, I can always change the colors of the chart. Pretty cool. Keep on going. Back to my data, go back. I'm not gonna sit here and do every one of these. Here is a donut chart. And then this last one says the invoice amount and the cost, column E and column F, appear highly correlated. That's true because I put the numbers in there and I did, I think, 0.89 or 0.89 to 0.91 for the cost. So I knew that this would be true. And before you say, Chris, it only gave you these 4 little options. That's not very helpful. No, it says show more right here. Scroll down. I'm not going to sit here and go through all this. But you have a lot more options when you come through here. Really, really cool stuff in here. What I like about it is it's possible there's stuff in here that I didn't even think about doing. Now let's go back to the top. So we've looked at not sure what task. We've looked at the charts and pivot tables that it automatically created. But why don't we just ask it a question ourselves? When I click here, again, it's got suggested questions, but I'm just going to make this question up. What was the total invoice amount for Ford? I'm not going to do a question mark. It knows that it's a question. And there it is, 3398336. Let's test it real quick. I want to see if that's correct. We already got our filters running. Just go and filter by Ford. Hit OK. Highlight column E. Look down in your status bar on the right. There is the word sum. Perfect, perfect match, which it should be a perfect match. And there you go. I could continue to come in here and ask questions about the data. Let me turn off the filters, Control Shift L. Anyway, I can keep going here. What? I'm gonna do a month one. What month was the highest for invoice amount? I'm just kind of curious. 2022 of October. There you go. 2400. How about it? And I could insert that. I'll go ahead and insert it. There you go, right there. Very, very cool. That is analyze data feature. It sits on the home tab in Microsoft Excel. Feel free to catch me at EA Ignite. If you can't, I will put a link to other public speaking events that I do. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe. Feel free to check out my blog. I'll put a link in that in the description down below also, along with this file with just this one worksheet to start off with that I created. Thank you.